Welcome to my studio. Here are a few views of my space, which I feel very fortunate to have. It's a bit chaotic, but that's my creative process in action. Windows on three walls bring in great light all day long. Let's take a look out that back window into our natural oasis, where we are visited daily by birds and chipmunks, the occasional skunk and possum, raccoon, rabbits, even a coyote once in a while. The water flows towards me, fueling my creative juices all day long. Okay, back inside. Here's my journal. Every night when I finish photographing my pages, I weight it down with these marble slabs to help control the bulging and potential breaking of the book's spine. I place sheets of waxed paper between the painted pages so that they don't stick together during the pressing. As you can see, it's still pretty bulgy. I usually begin my process with words. I have a lot of them. I've been collecting them for a very long time, but especially since moving into New York in 2001. At one point, I did actually keep them organized and filed into categories, but that went to the wayside when I realized too many phrases fell into multiple categories, and I had no way of cross-referencing them. I still begin each day with that day's newspaper. Sometimes these images are inspired by the words, but sometimes I look for words to support an image already in my mind's eye. This day the words came first. After I chose my pages, which often have words printed on them that fit my theme, I glue two together to create a strong foundation to work on. I begin to place items and sometimes make sketches as I did here because I decided to make a stamp. I drew my design on paper and transferred it onto the rubber by placing the pencil drawing face down and tracing over it from the back with pen, creating a kind of old-fashioned carbon paper. Once transferred, I darken the lines, carve the image, and adhere the rubber to a piece of plexiglass for easier placement and handling once stamping. I give it a few test runs, clean up some lines, and move on to the next step. Here is when I begin by gessoing the pages. I put on a medium dense coat, not too heavy, not too light. And once dry, which I use the blow dryer for because I'm not quite patient enough to watch paint dry, I will sand the pages with 400 grit super fine sandpaper. Then I clean off all the sanding dust and I lay down color. Usually I do several layers. This time I started with two, red and then yellow. I like to rub the paint in like a stain. It helps bring up the texture of the gessoed brush strokes. After rubbing in the paint and letting it dry a little, I drew a few winged figures and photocopied them to make photocopy transfers. I cut them out and place them where I want them before adhering them face down with acrylic matte medium. Then I burnish them onto the page well so there are no bubbles and I let them dry. Again, I use the blow dryer to help expedite the process. Once completely dry, I spritz the back of the image with water and begin to carefully rub away until all that is left is the image. Before adding another layer of images, I painted in the flames and rubbed in another coat of a goldy yellow. Then I followed with the stamp, more transfers, repeating the process until I was completely satisfied. Once everything is all dry, I put a coat of acrylic matte varnish on, which I rubbed in because I didn't want to see another conflicting layer of brush strokes. And last but not least, I photograph the images, post them to share with you my journey of the day on my blog, and that's it. Thanks for watching. Now go make art. Take care.